Welcome to That American Football Show, powered by EP Sports. EP Sports is a top supplier in the UK for all your American football needs, helping players and coaches reach their potential since 2007. Check them out at epsports.co.uk. Today, we've got our first double interview of the ELF Ballers series. We're joined by quarterback and tight end for the Stuttgart Surge, Randy Schroeder and David Meza. Randy comes from North Carolina, was an all-state quarterback for Mooresville High School, and was recently the two times National League champion for the Copenhagen Towers, which is the Denmark League. And David has already spent a year with the Surge, if you've been following the ELF. But his accolades include being the first team all-CCIW with Carroll University. But guys, thank you for taking the time out of your day to join us. How have you guys been?
Doing well. I just landed here back in Monday, so been here for about a week. So all moved in, just living the life, you know, back in Stuttgart. So ready to roll.
Yep, just trying to get acclimated here. It's been good so far. Thank you guys for having us.
Oh, no problem. Are you staying in the same place, David?
No, so I'm staying in the same neighborhood. But I'm living with our linebacker, Ronnie Lakalaka. So he hasn't gotten out here yet, but I'm living with him. And Randy's living with our other defensive import, Malcolm Washington. So
are you guys close to each other in Stuttgart?
It's 20 minutes driving.
What's your suggestion? First thing that Randy should like taste or go to in Stuttgart?
I mean, Duna, you know, the kebab, the Turkish kebab. I'm sure you guys have had it. It's
too many times.
I love it, but I mean, Randy has had it before and we've already gotten some. So,
hey, I had some tonight actually for dinner.
He's eating more dinner than me.
Yeah.
I love it. It's a staple of my diet when I'm out here.
Athlete diet.
German Doner must be really good because there's now a chain of German Doner kebab restaurants in Britain.
So, oh, really?
I've not been yet, so I think I might give it a try.
I know there's one of them recently.
Yeah, there's one in Edinburgh.
Like German Doner kebab or something.
Looks just like a British Doner kebab.
Yeah, they're everywhere. It's like Van cafes on every corner.
Yeah, it's very European.
Yeah, it's cool.
Right next to where we live is a... I also live with the kicker. He's from Italy. So there's a like an authentic Italian place right next door. So we went there the other night. He was like, "We're not going to eat here if they don't speak Italian to me." We walk in and start speaking Italian. We got food. It was amazing. Pizza was great. So we got some good restaurants around here.
Good to have a local with you.
Yeah.
So first question's for you, Randy. After your first season with Copenhagen in 2008, I read an interview you nearly retired from the game, and it was the Towers giving you a call back that brought you back into the game. What were your thoughts about retirement, and how was your time away? And what did you learn about yourself and, you know, the future idea outside football?
Yeah, it was an interesting time. It was right after COVID. So our season was canceled and went back home and started working, and I was enjoying work a lot. And I was also coaching high school. I had to be involved in the game somehow. And I loved it. Like my wife and I were kind of settling down. We were enjoying the life that we had. And I remember one day she said to me, like, we talked about retiring for a while officially. And we decided we officially would retire. I would retire. And I remember she said to me, the only place I would consider going back would be Copenhagen if they offered, I hadn't spoken to him since. So I mean, I hadn't spoken to him for a year or two. And out of the blue, I got a message from the GM asking me to talk, and they offered me to come back. So kind of crazy that I'm still playing, considering the circumstances, but my time away was great. I think it made me realize that there's definitely things outside of football, but it also, and when I got that call from Copenhagen, I was just so I was so excited because you realize how much you miss it when you're actually away from the game, you know? And I mean, now I can't think of doing anything, you know, doing anything else with my time. So, yeah.
It is kind of one of those things, though, isn't it? Once you get in, it's so hard to just come out and live a life that's any different away from, yeah, you say your life revolves around football constantly, and then having that taken away. I know you said you do a bit of high school coaching, but it's even though that's good fun and it's nice, it's not the same as it is actually being on that field and sort of dictating how the game goes.
Yeah, no, for sure. It was great. I had to be involved somehow. And I mean, the place we coached at, it was a great program. So we were, I mean, I was coaching from like 3 to 8 and games on Friday nights and film for 10 hours on Saturday and meetings for 5 hours on Sunday. So I felt like I was in it, but you just don't get the same feeling as you do, you know, walking out on the field in front of thousands of people and, you know, playing with your teammates. It's just a different, you feel removed in a sense. So I love, you know, having that feeling back again.
Yeah, for sure. And David, you were one of the earlier returning import players for the ELF. And this is sort of like a two-part question. Like, number one, how did you enjoy your first season? What stood out? And what are the reasons you came back? And then second of all, like, what are your expectations for this season? You know, more teams in the league, even though it's the same league, it's going to be a lot of changes.
First season, I enjoyed it. It had its ups and downs, you know. Obviously, you guys followed along. Wasn't the best season in Stuttgart, and you can tell with social media, a lot of people have their doubts about us, especially going into the second season of the ELF. But why I returned is just because I think, one, I enjoy the city. Stuttgart is a wonderful city to live in. Two, I knew that Coach Martin, he has always been successful throughout his career as a coach. And he has even said this himself, going into that first season in the ELF, he wasn't prepared for the level of play. And after this offseason, seeing everyone sign, you can just tell that we're loading up to be a competitive team. I mean, we have a crap load of studs on defense, and that was awesome to see. We had practice on Sunday. So I was able to see like how much better we are this season, and it's unbelievable. So from my expectations going into the second season is just to be competitive week in, week out. I love the fact that we're in the central division with the two Austrian teams, you know, Swarco, Vienna, both have great legacies as programs, and then the returning champs in Frankfurt. So I think it's a great challenge for us within our division, and then went outside of our division and hopefully make a playoff run, you know.
Yeah, we had Sean Shelton on from the Raiders, their quarterback, and like it's going to be exciting seeing those two teams come in from Vienna and Swarco, because they're big teams from their old leagues.
Right, that's another thing that's super exciting with, I know some people, especially the clubs, you know, you got your Italian clubs, your Polish clubs, the teams in the Scandinavian leagues, they are kind of anti-ELF.
Yeah.
But I think as it turns into a more professional league, you know, you get your 10 European imports getting paid, your American imports getting paid, and hopefully the wage of all of our players are paid, but the local guys aren't, they're paid the bare minimum. I know there's like a salary floor for them, but I think this league is going to go in the right direction. Within 10 years, everyone's going to be on a professional level. And I think that's what Europe needs, because it's going to increase the competitive level.
Yeah, I mean, we were banging on about that all last year, saying it's going to be the top league for Europe at least, which is something for people to aim for.
Right. And then when you add teams like the Raiders and the Vikings, just ups it. And, you know, people will follow suit, so...
Yeah, that the quality in your division, you mentioned it there, you've got the two Austrians and then obviously Frankfurt, but you guys as well, it's quite easy. I've seen people say online, you know, Stuttgart, you mentioned last season, didn't go to plan, and some people think that there could be, that you guys may potentially struggle, but I don't think what people realize is your team is pretty young. And you mentioned how your head coach admitted he, you know, wasn't quite ready. You've got the ability there to almost shape and put in the foundations of a team that could actually be rather successful this year. And I think sometimes people look past that. I don't know if that's the sort of feeling in your camp as well, just that feeling that there's a high potential that goes along with the Stuttgart surge this year.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, we had a lot of 19, 20-year-old guys. I mean, we lost Marcel Dabo. Awesome for him, though. I'm excited to see how he does in the IPP program with the Colts. And then we lost Luis Geyer to Cologne, but best of luck to him. And then we have a bunch of guys that kind of lurked in the shadows. They didn't have the, recognition that those two guys had. But Julian Ludwig, he plays safety for us. He's a stud. He's younger. We got a bunch of guys at receiver that are really young. So like you said, there's a lot of upside to these guys. And who knows what their ceiling is when it comes to growth potential.
Yeah, that's what I like about the LF. There's nearly everyone you don't know. So you welcome the surprises.
Exactly.
What was it, Randy, that brought you over to the ELF? Did you manage to see any of it last year, and how much did you know about it?
Yeah, I followed it all season. Being in Denmark, we played, I think, April through October. So it's pretty much the same time as the ELF. So, you try and follow all the teams in Europe and it's fun watching the games when you have a bye week or something. I watched the championship game. I would watch the highlights, and just looked to me like it was taking off. After the season with Denmark, Martin reached out to me, the head coach, and we just had a few interviews, and I felt like it was the longest interview process ever. I would talk with him, and then I talk with him again, and then I talk with him again, and then I talk with Coach Streeter or another coach, and my head was swimming a little bit. But we had a lot of meetings, a lot of interviews, and I think it was kind of both of us interviewing each other, seeing if we'd be a good fit. That's kind of how it all started, and how I decided to come to the Surge.
Okay, so with this next question, the fact that you've watched the ELF, you might be able to help answer this next question. But David, mainly, who did you play last year that you're really looking forward to playing against again? Either of you, is there names of guys maybe we don't know about that are new coming into the league? Or is there anyone for you, Randy, that you're looking forward to playing to that you've seen?
David, you go ahead, man. I'll follow up.
I mean, I think there's a natural rivalry between us and Barcelona, and I'm happy we got two games against them in our out-of-division games. I'm interested in our games against Wrocław, just because we didn't get to play them last season. So that would be fun going up to Poland, playing them, because I know they got a great team. And the Austrian teams, excited to play them. I think you don't really – we recognize guys throughout the season and, see them do highlights or through other ways. But I think when guys stand out is really through film. So it's tough to say because, we're still in camp. You don't really know how teams are shaping out, who the starters are going to be, who you're looking forward to, and what kind of matchups you're going to see. So that second part of that question is tough to answer, but I'm excited to play everyone, essentially.
Yeah, I can't really I didn't play last year in the ELF, so I don't have, that team that I really want to face. But back in Copenhagen, we were in the CEFL before there was the ELF, and we played Swarco, so I'd love to go into Swarco and play them. They just got such a beautiful stadium. And I've kind of ridden a train through Innsbruck. I would love to go there and play. Sean and I know each other. He played in my conference in college. So, I would love another shot at them, because they definitely got the best of us when we played them in 2018. So I think I'm looking forward to that game a lot.
Yeah, it's a good one to look forward to. Just give a shout out to our boy Justin Rogers, number 23 for the Sea Devils. He's dangerous to play against in the backfield.
Yeah, that's exciting.
Justin Rogers is, he's a good player. Yeah.
We don't need to shine his ego anymore. I know he'll be listening to this and Justin. So you obviously both said you've not long got into Germany, but have you had a chance to work out and throw the ball together yet? And what are you both looking forward to working with each other?
Yeah, we've got the opportunity. We had our first camp on Sunday, and then we've been throwing with the receivers regularly during the week while we don't have practice. So we've been on the field three times or so together now, and it's been great. I just love how hungry the guys are. I think David kind of hit on it, but Lewis left, but there's a little bit of a void, and it's cool to see the guys really step up and how bad they want it. We're throwing, constantly. We just had a receivers meeting last night with them, just me and the receivers watching film from practice on Sunday. But most of the guys were on there. So just cool to see, how eager everyone is to have such a good season. And David, what do you think?
And obviously I'm excited to work with Randy, just cause I think we're going to tear up the middle of the field. It's going to be fun, but like Randy said, with Lewis leaving, there's a lot of who's going to step up, who's going to fill this spot. And we got a bunch of receivers. We got Luca. I forget his last name. He played for the Stuttgart Scorpions last season. He looks phenomenal. Enrico Pascal, he played for Schroeder Hall. I think he can step up. Noah Bamba from Frankfurt, he has a chance to step up. We got a bunch of young guys that are ready to fill that void that Lewis has left. And Paul Segervald, who's returning, he's going to be a stud outside. I think our pass game is in good hands, especially with Randy. So I'm excited.
Yeah, I'm excited. You only talk about passing over the middle and unlocked deep memory. That I'm only 5'10" and played fullbacks. So they wouldn't let me be a tight end, no matter how much I asked. And I always wanted to catch a ball down the middle, and I never did. Anyway, side note aside, David, I saw in a previous interview, you mentioned a bit of disc golf back in Berlin. When I worked over in America, I loved the bit of frolf. How much were you into it, and what other kind of sports are you into?
That's not a real word.
Frolf.
Frisbee golf.
Yeah.
You're winding me up. That's real.
That's too funny. I'm trying to recall which interview that was. But so growing up, we had a really nice 8-hole golf course or disc golf course in my town, and really small town. I grew up in a population of 5,000 people, so not much to do. So we picked up disc golfing. We'd go down after school, after practice, and get in a few rounds, and it was a blast. I actually haven't done it in a few years, but when I did do it, best time of my life.
Such a good game.
Yeah. Other sports, I don't know. I used to skateboard sometimes, roll around here and there, but got to be careful because not trying to get injured,
Yeah, skateboarding. So,
yeah.
This could see you skateboarding around Stuttgart with the hill.
There's too many hills. Skateboarding up that, I'll have to pass.
Be rough.
Sorry, frisbee golf, is that the one with like the chains?
Yeah,
the chain basket.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen
it. It's not like a British beach frisbee. It's like a proper disc. Like they can get some. Yeah.
You have drivers. You have putters.
Yeah, it's really. And you throw it. You flick it, and it's fucking nuts.
Okay. Might need to give that a go.
You got a YouTube professional disc golf. Some of those guys are unreal.
Some of the hole in one. It's crazy. Defy humanity.
Yeah, those don't make any sense.
Randy, as we mentioned, you've played a fair bit in Denmark. Beauty about the ELF is that you get to play in many different countries. So, what cities are you looking forward to going to? And in the future as well, I mean, you know, in the ELF with the potential expansion, what other cities would you like to be playing a bit of football in?
Well, I would love for more of the Nordic cities to join, having played up there. I know there's kind of a push up. I wouldn't be surprised to see a Nordic team. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised, whether it's Helsinki or Copenhagen. We'll see, but I wouldn't be surprised, or Stockholm. Cities this year, though, I'm really looking forward to going to Barcelona. I've never been playing some football there, and I've spent a little bit of time in Vienna, but it's beautiful. So going back there would be really cool. But yeah, I think Barcelona is the top of my list. It's going to be hot in August, though. But
yeah.
Cool. Yeah.
You're from North Carolina. You'll be good.
Yeah, I'm from North Carolina. My roommate here, Malcolm's from Houston. So we'll be good. It's David I'm worried about.
Wisconsin boy.
Yeah.
The fourth quarter is going to be rough. I know
it. It was like, 90 degrees Fahrenheit back home today. So. Yeah, I'm used to it.
Blimey.
Okay. And so for our final question, this is a question we've asked every guest so far. You might be familiar with the concept. It's the desert island game. You're on a desert island for a year. You get to bring one of each of the following things. We've got five of them. We'll just alternate between you as we go. We'll get two answers for each. First thing you get to bring with you is one meal you will have every day of the year. David, what are you bringing?
I mean, that's tough because I'd probably just go with steak, just because there's a lot of micronutrients. You know, if I don't have vitamins, might as well just eat a steak. I'm sure there's fruit on the island, so fruit and steak. Oh. Yeah.
What about you, Randy?
Ooh, that's tough. I would say pizza, but that would get old real quick. Honestly, I think if there's not fruit on the island, I would like a nice fruit bowl of kind of everything, pineapple, some blueberries, strawberry. Every day I could wake up and eat that for sure.
Maybe we'll bend the rules and say you're allowed to bring multiple foods in a fruit bowl.
I like that. It's very underrated answer, that, I think.
Yeah. Although that's solid, cold, let me tell you that.
That's true.
Second thing you got to bring with you is a musical album. Randy, you can start this one off.
Oof, put me on the spot here. Musical album. And this is where my lack of music prowess is going to come back to bite me in the butt. I don't know. I'll probably bring some old Michael Jackson music.
Okay.
I think I could. I think they keep me in a good mood, you know.
Mm-hmm. MJ's a solid. Yeah.
It doesn't ever get old, you know.
Don't stop till you get enough.
Yeah. There you go. It's thrilling.
Beat it. Right, come on, David, your turn.
First thing off the top of my head was Kid Cudi, Man on the Moon.
Ooh,
nice.
So just like that. Grew up a hip hop guys, so
yeah, I like that. Could he? Third one, you got to bring a celebrity with you. They can be alive, or you can have them alive if they are dead at the prime of their life. I'll start with you this one, David.
Probably Bear Grylls.
Oh, smart.
That is
probably smart. Bear Grylls. Yeah, just the answer explains itself. We're good. Randy, you're up.
Can I also say Bear Grylls? That's the smartest
it's
answer.
It's a cop out. You can both have Bear Grylls.
Yeah, why would you not want Bear Grylls if you're on a deserted island?
This is the posh Englishness. Would that not get on your nerves after a while, Bear Grylls? Golly gosh, people.
It just makes me think of all the answers of Tom Brady and Jessica Alba, and they're just all wrong.
Yeah.
You get to watch one sports team. You get a channel that unlimited sports team, but one team. Who are you bringing, Randy?
Panthers, man.
Panthers.
Ride or die. Yep.
Dave?
Packers.
Both Packers. Okay, both American football. That's what we love to see.
I really should have gone safe and said the Stuttgart Surge, but Panthers.
No, they're not going to be playing with their quarterback.
Yeah.
And fifth, you do have, this one's a drink. You do have water available, so that's not a need. But what is the one drink you are bringing with you, David?
That's tough.
Do you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain?
Yeah, I mean, I love pina coladas, but that's like a cocktail, kind of like it's a mixture.
You can have a cocktail as a drink. A mixed drink is fine. So if you like Jack and Coke and something.
Yeah, I think just like a Malibu rum, you know, just something simple.
Nice.
You know, something to sip on under the sun. Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
Dave's going to be enjoying his year in the island. Steak and rum. What about you, Randy?
I'm about to be real German here, but a drink I love here is Apfelschorle. It's like seltzer apple juice. It's amazing. I don't know why David makes fun of me, because I love it so much, but it's so good. Like, I have it here so much because you can't get it in the States. I would definitely bring that with me.
So is it just like do you guys have appetizer in America?
Not really, no.
A bit fizzy.
Fizzy apple juice.
Fizzy apple juice. No.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it is, but we don't have that in the States.
Yeah, we have it called appetizer.
It's quite nice.
Yeah, appetizer, boss. Mm-hmm. But that's it, boys. You've completed the interview. We've taken you a little bit over time, so apologies for that. But thank you so much for joining us. We've all had a good time. Is there any social medias you would like to plug? Any friends you want to give a shout out to? The next minute or two is absolutely your time.
Follow Stuttgart Surge on Twitter and Insta. They have Facebook as well, so.
Yeah, follow Randy. The team. I appreciate you guys having us on here. It's been a lot of fun.
You're welcome.
Yeah, check out the Stuttgart page. Follow us throughout the year.
Yeah, we'll get those links on this post when it's out. And we'll also make sure we get David and Randy tagged in so you can give them a follow. But yeah, boys, it's been an absolute pleasure. It's been really nice meeting you. And obviously nothing but the best for the upcoming season. We're all really looking forward to watching you kill it.
Appreciate it. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you, guys.
No worries. Make sure you are checking us out on our YouTube. It's That American Football Show. You can also find us on all of our socials, which are, Joe.
Yeah, Twitter and Instagram is at TAFS_UK. And our Facebook is That American Football Show.
Wherever you're listening from, please feel free to give us some feedback. Give us a comment. Let us know where you're listening from. We've got the map going. But yeah, again, good luck, boys. We'll be keeping in touch with you, making sure you're doing well. Everyone, thank you for listening. Make sure you head over and check out our friends at EP Sports for all your NFL and equipment needs, and we will see you next time.